I feel like as women, we are on this lifelong mission to find fabulous makeup products, and there are so many options out there. We need it to make us look good. We need it to not break the bank. We need it to have fabulous consistency, not break out our skin. Like, there's so many factors that go into that. And I'm so happy that I found Shine Makeup earlier this year because it gives me all the things that I need. It doesn't break the bank. The consistency is my favorite out of any makeup that I've ever tried. The people behind Shine Makeup are absolutely amazing, but I will say the best part about Shine Makeup is I know that everybody that I share it with is going to love it just as much as I do.
Welcome to the I Am Mom Summit. I am Nagina Abdullah, health coach for busy moms, and I have a ton of amazing content for you in store today. I'm going to talk about 5 healthy cooking hacks to save 5 hours in the kitchen each week so you can lose weight and spend more time with your kids. And all of these hacks are applicable to paleo, to keto, to any kind of diet or any kind of food kind of habits that you have. It's really about getting in and out of the kitchen quickly or at least having strategic ways to cook for your family and for yourself and stay healthy. Now, I want to let you know that today we're going to talk about how to make Sunday meal prep feel short and sweet. I'm going to share shortcuts to make meal prep even faster and easier. I'm going to share storage hacks so you can make ahead and freeze or refrigerate up to 4 times each recipe. I'm going to tell you exactly even what storage containers to use. And I'm also going to share easy cooking techniques so that you can spend less time in the kitchen. Now, the last hack that I have, hack number 5, is a super hack where I'm going to teach you the top 5 hands-off cooking methods that don't require you to dirty a lot of dishes either, so that you can hang out with your kids or not, whatever you choose. Now, stay till the end so that you can learn this. This training is specifically for busy moms who only have time to grab a banana as you're running out the door, whether you're taking your kids to school or whether you're rushing off to work. You really don't have that much time to have an elaborate meal. This training is also for busy moms who don't have time to even buy a salad in the middle of their day, whether you're working or whether you're at home, let alone making something. And this training is also for busy moms who come home tired and you feel like you need to treat yourself, often with takeout or wine or grilled cheese. Now, I'm going to share my screen really quickly because I want to show you a picture, a couple pictures of me and kind of how I've evolved. So let's see. Let me just present this now. So just to share a little bit about me, I'm Nagina Abdullah. That's me in my kitchen. I'm a health coach for busy moms. I love to eat, and I think about it a lot. I love eating, especially chocolate croissants. They're my favorite, and I actually live next door to a bakery, which is fortunate and unfortunate. I call it dangerous. So I always have to have really good food in my house to keep me from just running out and getting it. Now, I desperately wanted to lose weight after I had 2 kids, so I researched every single thing I could possibly find. This is a picture of my before and after. I lost 40 pounds after having 2 kids. So this picture of me on the left is after my 2nd child. I'll show you a picture of my kids just coming up right now. I have 2 kids, and the picture of me on the left is when I was at my heaviest. I was actually, I didn't know I had 20 pounds more than my pre-pregnancy weight, and it wasn't budging. I didn't know what to do. I also never really got to my ideal weight before kids. And so what happened is after I had kids, I realized I need to do something. I need to figure out how to get healthier. And what I started doing is cooking my food really easily, making it mindless for me to cook and for me to know what healthy items to eat every day. And that is the way that I lost 40 pounds or 18 kilos after having 2 kids. And I used the quick cooking hacks that I'm going to share with you today in the training. So make sure to pay attention to every single thing. I really suggest that you get a notepad and take notes because I'm going to be sharing a lot of really, really key information. Let me just stop sharing real quick. Oh, wait, actually, let me show you. Okay. Now, this is a picture of my family at my son's 6th birthday after I implemented quick cooking hacks. Now, you'll see that I'm here with my husband, my mom, dad, and then my son and my daughter. And yes, I wore a crop top to his birthday because, first of all, it was really hot. I was in Sacramento, California in July. It was 90 plus degrees. And second of all, I just felt like that's what I wanted to wear. I felt great in it, and I felt like, why not? Like, why is there this stereotype that we have to feel and look frumpy and feel and look like we're tired and uncomfortable? I just really wanted to be who I was. And so part of the thing I had aspired to my entire life was to be able to wear a crop top. And the fact that I was able to do it at my son's 6th birthday for the first time, I just want to share that with you because I want to show you that it is possible for you to have the body that you really want to have, if that's what you want. And it's really about eating healthy foods, but the secret is making it easy to put it on the table. Because when it's difficult, you just don't feel like doing it. And as a mom, we have so many other things going on that we push ourselves to the back. So when you can make eating and cooking healthy easy for you, you're going to do it much more consistently. Now I'm back. So now I'm going to just jump right into the content. Okay, so let's see. I want to jump right in. So now let's start. I'm going to share 5 hacks to save 5 hours in the kitchen. And this is going to be amazing. So like I said, please get a notepad out, get anything that you need, because I'm going to share a lot of information. So hack number 1, we've all heard about Sunday prep. So Sunday prep is really key because once the week gets started, it's super hard to fit in healthy cooking in between all of the drop-offs, school, practices, work. There's just a lot going on. So if you really want to stay consistent, you want to do a little bit of work on Sunday. Now, what that means, it doesn't mean spending your whole Sunday prepping. What it means is doing a few things here and there to make your week easier. Think of it as just giving yourself that time and that space during the week. And so to do that, you're going to do a little bit of upfront work. Now, here's a few tips that I have for Sunday prep. These are the things that you can focus on doing. First of all, if you have anything to chop, chop it up on Sunday. You can cook it, but you can at least at a minimum chop it. So for example, if you have ginger, if you have garlic, if you have veggies, chop it for the week all at once and store it in a Ziploc or a plastic bag or a small or, you know, Tupperware glass container. Put it in the fridge. Now, I'm a big fan of smoothies. Smoothies are really an easy way for you to stay healthy and lean. And it's also, it doesn't take time at all. It can take less than a minute to make a smoothie. But to make it even easier to make a smoothie and to really just take out the mind space that you need when you're thinking about the ingredients that go in there, you can actually prepare your week's smoothies ahead of time or the night before by putting all of the ingredients in a Ziploc bag. So you could throw some greens in there, some berries or some fruit, any flavorings, and just put it into your freezer. And then in the morning, you just put it into your blender, or you can do that the night before. And then you add some liquid and maybe some protein to it. And that's a great way to make smoothies and plan ahead. On Sundays, I think it's a great idea to use either an Instapot or a pressure cooker or your slow cooker, because if you're around, you can actually cook something. Some really great things if you can cook ahead of time are some protein, whether it's chicken or beef or tofu. Try to get that out of the way, or at least marinate it. Get that going so you have a main dish. And then roast some vegetables. So you could roast a whole tray of vegetables, and that could be a side for you for 3 or 4 days. And so what you do to roast vegetables is you use a big tray, you use a big sheet pan, and you put the oven at 425 degrees Fahrenheit or 220 degrees Celsius, and you roast it for 12 to 15 minutes. So an example of vegetables that I like to roast are asparagus, Brussels sprouts, and broccoli, but you can do anything. Now, one quick kind of way to think about Sunday prep, those are some quick tips, but some kind of strategic ways to approach Sunday prep is what I like to do is to make two sides during Sunday prep. This makes it easier because sometimes the sides take a while, but during your week, you can quickly make the main part of it, the meat or the protein. You can quickly saute it or roast that. Now, if you've already made it, like I recommended through a Instapot or a pressure cooker or a crock pot, that's even better. But at a minimum, making the two sides during the week is going to really make it easy for you to put together a whole meal. So some examples of sides that you can make on the weekend are beans, such as black beans or curry garbanzo beans. You can either use canned beans that you rinse, or you can actually make it in the crock pot and add some flavors and spices. You can also do the vegetables like I recommended, a tray of vegetables, or you could saute some vegetables. And you can also do a healthy carb, such as quinoa or sweet potatoes during your Sunday prep. So during your Sunday prep, it's really about kind of giving yourself some shortcuts for the week so that when you come home, you kind of have a lot of things done. Now, hack number two. Hack number two is to plan leftovers. Don't make it an accident that you have leftovers. Actually plan leftovers. And the way to do this is to batch cook. So when you're making a meal, never only make a meal for only one serving. Always make it for at least three servings. And what you can do is you can have what you have for dinner, for example, on Monday night. And even if the family's eating it, then you could have it for lunch on Tuesday. Maybe you and your partner could have it. And then you can have it again for dinner, maybe on Wednesday night, so that you can skip a day. Because a lot of times with kids, they don't like to eat the same thing every night. So what you can do is just skip, and then it won't seem as close, or you can mix and match. So if you're having the black beans and the vegetables, you can mix and match the protein that you have with it or something like that. So you're also keeping it different. Some other ways to use these leftovers. So you could do dinner for lunch, like I talked about. You can also do dinner times three. So you could eat the same dinner for 3 days, and you could either mix and match or eat the same dinner. Sometimes adults are a lot better at eating the same thing. So maybe you eat similar things and then switch some of it up for the kids. And then also I recommend having the same breakfast every day, because a lot of times in the morning, we really need to just eat and get out of the house. We're not really looking for as much variety as we tend to look for, especially during dinner. So try to streamline your breakfast and make it really consistent. The same thing every day, or maybe you have two, maybe three breakfasts that you switch between for each week. So you're pretty consistent overall. Okay, now I want to actually share my screen again, because I want to show you my my storage secrets. So what I recommend when you batch cook is that you definitely want to fill up on the amount of glass containers that you have. It's much easier as a mom to know what containers you can use for storing food than kind of like going through your cabinets and finding covers and hoping they match with a Tupperware that you have. Definitely, it's great to just buy it in sets, because it just saves you time and it's so much more organized. You feel so good. So something like this is a glass lock set, and it has 10 pieces to it. I recommend buying two of these sets so that you have time, so that you have the space to really batch cook and whether it's freeze or refrigerate the larger portions of your meals. And so this is not you don't have to buy this exact one, but I'm just giving you an idea of like different shapes and sizes. Buy enough. A lot of times you need two 10-piece ones, especially if you have a family. Okay, so I wanted to show you that. Now, hack number three is to freeze larger portions. Like I was saying with batch cooking, you can actually, you know, batch cook and have leftovers for the week. But another way to actually layer that and make it even more, more useful that time, if you're going to cook, like take advantage of that time you're cooking. That's basically the message. What you're doing when you freeze a larger portion is that you're giving yourself a gift. Because imagine opening your freezer a week from now and you didn't even cook anything and you open it up and there's a beautiful black bean chili in there that you can just take out and you can defrost it in the morning so it's ready for dinner time. And maybe you had the same chili last week, but it's been a whole week. And so it's okay to have it again. And you could change it up if you need to. So you could add different things on top, or you could put it in a sandwich or something like that. So I want to give you some ideas of some good things that you can freeze, because that's what a lot of times I hear questions about: what are the best things to freeze? So you want to, things like chili. That's amazing. Chili is amazing to freeze. Stew. Things like a stew with meat and with vegetables, like little piece of vegetables, that's great. Curries, so chicken curry, beef curry, even fish curry, you can actually cook it and freeze it and it's completely fine. And then also chicken, beef, or meat are great to freeze. And you can freeze them whether they're uncooked so that you just know that you have something already there. You can marinate this and then you could freeze it. Or you can actually cook it and freeze it. I personally have some chicken tikka masala that I made in the crock pot. And I made it in a big batch so that my husband could take it to work. And it's super healthy. And so I have some. I have enough for the entire next week also, and it's in the freezer. And that's definitely going to be a gift to myself when I go there on Sunday. One thing that you don't want to freeze is if you roast vegetables or if you cook only vegetables, freezing that, depending on the vegetables, some freeze better than others, but just as a rule of thumb, it's easier to just not freeze vegetables unless they're cooked in something and it's not the main part of it. Okay. Hack number four. This is something that's pretty fun. So this is around experimenting with a few takeout restaurants so that you can find some healthy items and then you supplement with home cooked food. So sometimes we don't always have to cook everything. We can buy some things or get takeout and then we supplement so that we make it healthy. So I'm going to give you some exact examples so you know what I mean. So and part of it is that you can supplement. Part of it is that you can just order healthy and know what you're ordering. The reason I say experiment is because if you keep ordering from different places, you don't know how greasy one restaurant's food is. You don't know how much it's going to keep you full. So after you experiment and you realize, okay, this restaurant is good, I feel full and it's healthy, then you can just keep ordering. I'm really a fan of consistency when it comes to food, because you will really, really feel a lot better and be a lot healthier with that. So for example, American food, something that you could order is a delicious chopped salad. This is just an example. You could, of course, order so many other things. Delicious chopped salad with lots of protein on it, whether it's chicken or eggs or salmon. So you want to find a place that has a really filling chopped salad. That's key. For Mexican, you could order a burrito bowl, and that's a great thing to have at home. So these are also options if your kids want to have something, you can order them whatever they want, and then you order this healthier option. Of course, we want our kids to be healthy as well, so that's a separate subject, but for you, at the minimum, order something healthy. Now, if you're ordering from a deli or a diner, you could order meat or eggs and veggies. So that's kind of something that is an easy, healthy item. For Chinese, what you can do is you can order, they usually have a healthy steamed option. So you could order like steamed shrimp or steamed chicken and the sauce on the side always. Get that and then have some homemade cauliflower rice, or what I like to do is buy frozen cauliflower rice, but I just eat that with something like Chinese food. And then something similar, if you want to order Indian, you can do tandoori chicken, which is pretty healthy compared to all the other options. And then you can have that with homemade cauliflower rice. Okay, so finally, I want to share my hack number five. And this is the one that I'm so excited to share with you, because this is super packed with really great cooking techniques that I would love for you to look for when you're looking at recipes. Look for these cooking techniques because they're going to make it more hands-off, meaning like for roasting, for example, the example that I was telling you before, you just put it in the oven and then you walk away. You can spend time with your kids. You can spend time with yourself. You can do anything that you want, but you're not in the kitchen cooking. You also, these techniques that I'm going to share with you right now, they also are about making less dishes dirty. So you don't have to clean up as much. And I hope that's really amazing for you, because I love that. And also quick cooking. So the first of these five techniques The first one is what we talked about, roasting. So that's a hands-off technique. Look for roasting type of recipes. So roasting vegetables is one example, but you can roast a lot of things. You can roast salmon, you can roast chicken, you can do your chicken and vegetables in a sheet pan meal. So sheet pan meals are ideal for busy moms, because you can put vegetables and you can put a protein, put it in the oven in 15 to 20 minutes, it's done. And you can vary those things a lot, like what you're putting on the sheet pan. Another technique is using the crock pot. I really like using the crock pot because you put everything in the crock pot and then you set it and forget it. It's really another hands-off technique that works so well so that you can go do something else for four to six hours while the meal is cooking. And what I recommend for crock pots, the reason I like crock pots is that I even prefer them over Instapots. And the reason I prefer crock pots over Instapots is because they're bigger. And so you can use the leftover strategy where you're making something in big bulk in a crock pot. So chili is a great thing to make in a crock pot. Also something like a curry, a chicken tikka masala is a great thing to make in a crock pot. You can make, you know, 4 pounds or more of chicken for that, and then you can put half of it away, or you can eat it either way. The other and the third option for really great fast, quick, hands-off type cooking techniques are really looking for one skillet meals and stir fries. And the reason for this is because you put everything into one pan or one wok, you mix it all in there, you add your flavorings, you add your spices, and it's fast and it's less cleanup because it's all in one pot. So though you are standing there and stirring, it doesn't take very long for these types of meals, and also you're not using like 4 or 5 different dishes or pots and pans for your dinner. You're doing it pretty quickly. Now, the other two are something that they're not as common, but I definitely want to share them with you, and that is template meals. So template meals are like, you could have a template in your mind of what you want to have, like template recipes. So for example, you could do something like a chicken, a spiced chicken bowl, and it has certain spices, it has chicken, it has veggies on the side. And that's a template meal. You have a recipe for it and you make it once, but then the next week you could replace the chicken with beef, or you could replace some of the spices with a different marinade. So a template meal is really like sticking to a lot of similarities, like maybe the same recipe, but then you switch the actual ingredients, you switch the vegetable, or you switch the protein. And that way you're thinking less, and it's more systematic when you're grocery shopping, because you already know, okay, I'm gonna redo this recipe in a different way that nobody will know. And then finally, the fifth cooking technique is actually no cook options. And so these are things that instead of really cooking, what you can do is you can use some shortcuts, like using canned beans, canned tuna, canned chicken. Of course, rinse them off as much as you can because there's a lot of sodium on them. You can buy rotisserie chicken from somewhere like Whole Foods or another healthy foods grocery store, and then you can just use that on your salads or as your main and add a vegetable on the side. You can buy vegetables that are already, like, you don't really need to do anything with, such as like grape tomatoes, celery, and carrots. You don't have to cook them. You can just eat them. And then also using Ezekiel or sprouted grain or high fiber bread, and then that, which is a healthy bread. And then you can just kind of combine them with some of the other options I talked about. So just to summarize, these 5 cooking techniques: roasting, crock pot, one skillet meals and stir fries, template meals, and no cook options. And then overall, the 5 hacks for quick cooking are Sunday prep, plan your leftovers, freeze larger portions, and give yourself that gift. Experiment with a few takeout restaurants and supplement with home-cooked food, and then use the 5 hands-off, less dishes dirty, quick cooking techniques that I talked about. Now, I hope that you enjoyed those 5 techniques. I want to tell you one more thing that is really key in cooking quickly, and using spices is a really quick way to boost health benefits and flavor. And I have a special spice cheat sheet that's a free gift from me that I'm sharing with you for watching me on the I Am Mom Summit. The link is on the page. I'll be so excited for you to grab that. And after you grab that, I'll send you my recipe book, which is called 7 Spicy Recipes to Melt Off 7 Pounds. And that's something you'll get. And then we'll stay in contact because I'll send you more information after that. And we'll be in touch. So I'll send you recipes, more cooking hacks, lots of things to make your life easier while you're getting healthier. So thank you so much for watching today, and have a great rest of your day.